I personally felt that it was the future to build a system that eventually we'd become a net zero community.
Electricity demand in Ontario is growing at almost 2% per year for the next 20 years. And so that creates opportunities for innovation.
Our microgrid consists of a few components, the primary one being our battery energy storage device.
What battery storage in particular allows you to do is have the ability to support critical infrastructure. And it can be your town hall, it can be warming or cooling centers during those emergency situations when you need to support your community.
So that's number one, reliability, riding through the outage and keeping the lights on.
Many communities already have solar panels or battery storage and want to be able to contribute those to the grid while continuing to work on the development of their own sustainable programs at their community level.
We're trying to create clean power and then offload that clean power at crucial times so that we're able to, you know, sustain communities so they're able to grow, they're able to develop and maintain what they have.
Municipalities are really getting a lot of pressure to make changes in their system to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and batteries can really help with that.
The impacts on greenhouse gas emissions are huge.
Wind and solar are, you know, wonderful resources because they're renewable. The downside is you can't necessarily count on when it's going to be windy or when it's going to be sunny. So we introduced battery storage, and now we've got the option to store that energy when it's available and discharge it when it's not.
I think the more that we can invest in systems like this to produce green energy in different areas and put it within the communities themselves, I think is a smart way of the future.
Any electrical installation in our province is governed by the Electrical Safety Authority, and our microgrid is no different. We have, you know, strictly met all Ontario Electrical Code laws and rules.
It's not a huge, large structure. It's not visibly a negative impact on your community. There is no significant output of sound. It's not intrusive in the way of some other types of technology.
So would I recommend it? Absolutely. Let's all get on board. This is the future. We can make this happen for every community in Ontario.
Small teams and small towns can achieve big things.
This has the potential to help us deliver a more efficient, affordable, and reliable system, and that's good for all Ontarians.